Hello, good morning. Let us discuss one problem of synchronization. We know two types of process. One is cooperative process. Here synchronization problem occurs in case of cooperative process. What is cooperative process? If one process affect another process or affected by another process, then is called cooperative processes. Okay, so synchronization problem occurs in case of cooperative processes. Producer consumer problem is a synchronization problem. Let us know what is producer consumer problem. Here two conditions: if buffer is full, then producer is not allowed to produce any item. Case 2, if buffer is empty, then consumer is not allowed to consume any item from the buffer. And one important thing, in any point of time preemption may occur. Okay. So for this is the code for producer and this is the code for consumer. Yeah. For this buffer, this is buffer and n is the buffer size, that is 8, index started from 0 to 7. Two process, producer and consumer, both the process share the same buffer and also share count variable. Count variable is a global variable shared by both the processor, and in is a variable used for producer process, and also out is another variable used for consumer process. Producer int count is equal to 0. Void producer, void count, first we have initiated count variable as 0. Int item p, we have initialized one variable, we have declared one variable, that is item p. While true, then produce item, item p, we have produced one item, that is item p. Suppose that item p is x1. While count is equal to n, we are checking whether buffer is full or not. If buffer is full, then while loop is ended here, this is self loop. If this will be true, then while loop will continuously execute the same statement, and this is there is a loop. Okay, if this will false, then it will execute the next statement. Buffer in, here this is empty, so it will execute buffer in is equal to item p. So we have produced item p, that is x1. Now x1 will be produced and it will be inserted into buffer in slot 0, that is in variable. In is 0, so it will be inserted here x1. Okay, now in is equal to in plus 1 mod n. So now after the insertion of x1, it will be in is equal to in plus 1, that is 0 plus 1 mod 8, so that is 1. Now in variable changed to 1. Next statement, count is equal to count plus 1, that is count plus 1, 1. Okay, but inside processor this statement will execute in three steps, that is 3 micro instructions. First is load rp m count, that is memory, inside memory count variable is there, count location, from the count address it will be loaded to register, then increment the value of the register, then whatever register value will be assigned to memory. Okay, with this three step this count variable is incremented. Okay, now check for consumer. Int item C while true, while count equal to 0. Now count is what? 1. So this statement will false. If count is 0, then this will be a self loop. No further process, further statement will be executed. When count will be 0, if this buffer is empty, there is no item, then this will be 0. So consumer cannot consume any item. Next item, in this case this is false, so it will execute next statement. Item C equal to buffer out. What is the value of out? That is 0. Initially it will be 0, so at address 0 item C, what is item C? X1. So X1 will assign to item C. Now out variable will be changed. Out is equal to out plus 1 mod n. Out will be 1. Next count equal to count minus 1. Then count variable will be decremented. So count gives the number of item present inside the buffer. Next process item, item C. Then item C will be processed or consumed by the consumer. Here also count equal to count minus 1, this statement will be divided into 3 micro instructions. M count will assign to RC, then register C will decremented, then decremented value will be assigned to M count. Okay. So this is the best case where no issues will be there. After production of one item, consumer is consuming that item. So this is the best case. Now we will check the worst case, what will happen. So what will be the problem actually inside producer and consumer? Let's check this scenario. Here three items are present, x1, x2 and x3 in the buffer. In this situation count will be 3, because three items are present inside buffer, and in variable there is 3. In shows the next empty slot in the buffer, and out is a 0, no item is consumed by the consumer. Now first, this is the sequence. First execute producer problem. Producer is going to produce one item, so int count, int item p while true, produce item, item p, suppose x4 is produced. While count equal to n, count is not equal to n, buffer in equal to item p, item p will be x4 will be inserted into the buffer at position, what is n? 3. So here x4 will be inserted here. Okay, x4 is inserted. In equal to in plus 1 mod n, what will be in? So that will be 3 plus 1 4 mod 8, that will be 4. Now count equal to count plus 1. Here first micro instruction I1 is executed, that is M count load RP. In RP register P, what will be loaded? Count value will be loaded, that is 3. Next instruction, execute next instruction I2, instruction 2 of producer, that is RP increment RP, that will be 4. But before executing micro instruction 3, it is preempted. Preemption may occur at any time due to expire of time quantum or any hardware interrupt or due to priority. So after executing second in micro instruction, it is preempted. Now consumer process is started executing. So here int item c while true, while count equal to 0, count is not 0 here, then count is 3. So now item c equal to buffer out. Out is 0, no item is consumed before, so out x1 will be deleted. Now out value will be incremented, out plus 1, that is 1. Now count equal to count minus 1. So again load rc m count, execute count, what is the value of count, that is 3 will be loaded to rc. Decrement RC, so RC value is decremented, that is 2. Now before executing instruction 3, it is again preempted. After preemption, it will return from where it is preempted. So next third instruction will be executed. So store M count RP. What is the value of RP? RP is 4. Now 4 will be stored in count, so count value will be 4 here. This process is completed here. Now it will again return to the preempted code. So here store M count RC, so RC value will be stored to count. What is the value of RC? That is 2. Now 2 will be this is the sequence we have executed. We have executed instruction, first instruction I1P, then I2P, then I1C, then I2C, then I3P and I3C. Now both the processes are completed. If two process completed, here count variable must show the exact item present inside the buffer. But in this case, what it is the value? What is the value of count? It is 2. That means only 2 items are present inside buffer. This is the worst case. We are not getting the exact item present inside the buffer. This is all about producer consumer problem. Thank you.